Now, the star-belly sneetches had bellies with stars. The plain-belly sneetches had none upon bars. Those stars weren't so big. They were really so small, you might think such a thing wouldn't matter at all. But because they had stars, all the star-belly sneetches would brag,
"We're the best kind of sneetch on the beaches."
With their snoots in the air, they would sniff and they'd snort,
"We'll have nothing to do with the plain-belly sort."
And whenever they met some, when they were out walking, they'd hike right on past them without even talking. When the star-belly children went out to play ball, could the plain-belly get in the game? Not at all. You only could play if your bellies had stars, and the plain-belly children had none upon bars. When the star-belly sneetches had frankfurter roasts, or picnics, or parties, or marshmallow toasts, they never invited the plain-belly sneetches. They left them out cold in the dark of the beaches. They kept them away, never let them come near. And that's how they treated them, year after year. Then one day, it seems, while the plain-belly sneetches were moping and doping alone on the beaches, just sitting there, wishing their bellies had stars, a stranger zipped up in the strangest of cars.
"My friends," he announced in a voice clear and key, "my name is Sylvester McMonkey McBean, and I've heard of your troubles. I've heard you're unhappy, but I can fix that. I'm the fix-it-up chappy. I've come here to help you. I have what you need, and my prices are low, and I work at great speed, and my work is 100% guaranteed."
Then quickly, Sylvester McMonkey McBean put together a very peculiar machine, and he said,
"You want stars like a star-belly sneetch? My friends, you can have them for $3 each. Just pay me your money and hop right aboard."
So they clambered inside. Then the big machine roared. And it clumped, and it bumped, and it jerked, and it burped, and it bopped them about. But the thing really worked. When the plain-belly sneetches popped out, they had stars. They actually did. They had stars upon bars.
We've got stars now.
They yelled at the ones who had stars at the start.
"We're exactly like you. You can't tell us apart. We're all just the same now, you snooty old smarties. And now we can go to your Frankfurter parties."
Groaned the ones who had stars at the first.
"We're still the best sneetches, and they are the worst. But how now in the world will we know?"
They all frowned.
"If which kind is what, or the other way round?"
Then up came McBean with a very sly wink, and he said,
"Things are not quite as bad as you think. So you don't know who's who. That's perfectly true. But come with me, friends. Do you know what I'll do? I'll make you again the best sneetches on beaches, and all it will cost you is $10 eaches."
"Belly stars are no longer in style," said McBean. "What you need is a trip through my star off machine. This wondrous contraption will take off your stars, so you won't look like sneetches who have them on bars."
And that handy machine, working very precisely, removed all the stars from their tummies quite nicely. With their snoots in the air, they paraded about, and they opened their beaks and they let out a shout.
"We know who is who. Now there isn't a without the best kind of speeches are speeches without.
Then, of course, those with stars all got frightfully mad. To be wearing a star now was frightfully bad. Then, of course, old Sylvester McMonkey McBean invited them into his star-off machine. And, of course, from then on, as you probably guess, things really got into a horrible mess.
All the rest of that day on those wild screaming beaches, the fix-it-up chappy kept fixing up sneeches. Often, on again, in again, out again, through the machines they raced round and about again, changing their stars every minute or two. They kept paying money, they kept running through, until neither the plane nor the star bellies knew whether this one was that one or that one was this one or which one was what one or what one was who.
Then, when every last cent of their money was spent, the fix-it-up chappy packed up, and he went. And he laughed as he drove in his car up the beach.
They never will learn. No, you can't teach a sneech.
But McBean was quite wrong. I'm quite happy to say that the sneeches got really quite smart on that day. That day, they decided that sneeches are sneeches. And no kind of sneech is the best on the beaches. That day, all the sneeches forgot about stars and whether they had one or not upon bars.